Good morning, all. This is Maharshi.
Morning, sir.
Good morning. Ashish, sir, Rohit, and we have a Vishal, right?
Yes.
So, are we ready to start?
Yes, we can.
Perfect. Let's start then.
Okay. All
ball at your court.
Good morning, everyone.
Good morning.
Good morning. Like whenever Firebase comes in the mind, we thought for only two things. One is push notification and another is Crashlytics. We don't go beyond this, right? And how we can utilize Firebase in cross teams like marketing, development, quality team, analyze team, business team, etc., etc. So there are many another things we need to learn, we need to integrate in our future projects. So that can help us in many folds, right? So I'm going to share my screen and we will discuss on different aspect one by one. Okay, I just shared my screen. Is it visible?
Yes, visible.
Okay. So whenever we create any Firebase, so now what is Firebase? Firebase is a combination of different Google products, right? Earlier Crashlytics was from Fabric. Fabric has been acquired by Google. So now Firebase is a combination of Fabric plus Google Analytics. The project which I create in a Google that I can see in the Google Analytics. The website analytics, which generally like marketing team integrate and use it properly, right? But Google Analytics only for the marketing. Now, what about the Crashlytics, quality, push notification, and another functionality? So now Google has a one more product, which is a Firebase. So now everything is available here. So as you can see my screen, there are mainly four sections in the Firebase. One is develop, quality, analytics, and grow. Within this develop, we can create our online database, which is a Firestore. We can host this database in a cloud. We can connect through mobile applications, webs. We can utilize, we can do Google authentication for login functionality, storage, hosting, Google functions, machine learning, etc. Google functions like translate and etc. things are here available. So that can help us to make a application and a website. Then another thing, which is a quality. We always integrate a Crashlytics, but we haven't explored like performance, taste lab, and app distribution. Like these three functionalities can also help reducing a gap between development team and quality team. Development team and a client. So that will also help. This analytics part, that is for the marketing team, but that will only help when the analytics is being configured properly. So when they have a marketing project, they suggest a particular team leads and etc. to integrate Google Analytics or a Firebase Analytics, then only we take a part in that. But if we start from the first day, then we can take a very many fold benefits in through this analytics. And the another part, which is a grow, which has a predictions. We will go each and every functionality one by one in the depth. We will do the practical things here. So when we come to the cloud messaging, we only integrate a push notification, but we haven't explored remote config, predictions, A/B testing, and etc. So we will check each and everything. Right, but this all tools that can help. The basic concept is when we start integrating Firebase into our any project, mobile or a web project, from the day one, then it will have a good data and which can help us in the debugging, analytics, development, retention. Retention is also one more the important factor for the project and for the company as well. When we have a more retention factor, let's say we have a one client and we did go live, and after 6 months, 1 year, there is no business for the client and they shut the website or a mobile application and etc. Right? But when we provide them better retention through the analytics, through this Firebase tools, good quality, performance, etc., then customer will get a business. Customer will get a business. They will again come for the second phase with us. So we would not be in the required to new client every time, new project every time. We can have that same client, same account, another project from the same client, another phases in the same project. So this Firebase can help us in that area, right? So let's see one by one. So I'm going to hand over Rohit Singh from quality team, who is going to explain us about a quality, this four functionality. Then we will go one by one. Rohit, you can continue.
Thank you, Asya. Let me share my screen first. Is the screen is visible?
Yes, Rohit.
Okay. First of all, let me explain what is Crash Analytics. Right now, we are using in our couple of projects this feature. And if I can say in one sentence, Crash Analytics help us to track a crash which happens in the application. Suppose many times it happens ki hum jab release karte hain client ko, so suddenly sometimes crash happens on the mobile application and a client cannot able to reproduce again, and he mentioned to us in email or in communication, crash hua but I cannot able to reproduce that.
So sir, can you please come near to mic, please? Your voice is coming bit faint.
Okay. Hello, right now it is okay? Hello.
If possible, a bit louder.
Louder? Bagal wale aa jayenge sir. Hello.
Yes, this is better.
Okay. So I was telling ki when there a crash happens on the mobile application or somewhere in the application and it cannot be reproducible again, so this Crash Analytics help us to reproduce that crash. If you can see here on my screen, ये क्या करता है, आपको exception बताता है exact on the code line कहाँ पे वो crash हुआ. ये सारे वो दिख रहे हैं, ये हमारा एक application है. I am checking this grow app application over here, and if you can see here is a code line where the crash happens. तो ये आपको एग्जैक्ट वो कोड लाइन बताता है कहाँ पे क्रैश हुआ है, एंड द डेटा यू कैन गेट ओवर हियर. हमने जो 21st को ये एप्लीकेशन रिलीज किया था, देन ऑन दैट डे इट वाज 100% क्रैश फ्री, लेकिन जब यूजर ट्रैफिक बढ़ा, देयर वाज सम सिनेरियो हैपेंस ऑन द मोबाइल एप्लीकेशन, दे परफॉर्म्ड इट क्यूए ऑन द मोबाइल एप्लीकेशन, तो ये धीरे धीरे क्रैश हुआ. फिर उसके बाद पता चला कि कितने परसेंट क्रैशेस क्रैश फ्री हो रहा है और कितने क्रैशेस हैं, तो हमको यहाँ डेटा मिलता जा रहा है. तो उसमें क्या होगा कि ये क्लाइंट को बहुत ही हेल्पफुल रहता है, और या तो हम जब काम करते हैं, हमारे काम करने के टाइम भी दिस इज़ वेरी हेल्पफुल कि हम इजीली ट्रैक कर सकते हैं कि कहाँ पे एक्चुअल में एक्सेप्शन आया है, वे वी हैव टू हैंडल द एक्सेप्शन. क्योंकि मेरा भी अपना पर्सनल एक्सपीरियंस है, समटाइम्स वी ट्राई टू फाइंड अ सिंगल क्रैश सो मेनी टाइम्स, वी ट्राई टू रिप्रोड्यूस द सेम क्रैश अगेन एंड अगेन, बट वी कैन नॉट एबल टू डू दैट. तो एक्सेप्शन कभी कभार आता है, तो लेकिन यहाँ से हम एग्जैक्टली वो एक्सेप्शन देख सकते हैं. दिस क्रैश एनालिटिक्स इज ऑलरेडी इम्प्लीमेंटेड इन कपल ऑफ प्रोजेक्ट्स, एंड वी आर डूइंग बेटर इन सम पास्ट ईयर. और यहाँ पे भी आप देख सकते हो इवेंट ट्रेंड्स जो हैं, यहाँ पे आपको पता चलेगा कि कितने यूजर इफेक्ट होते हैं. तो ये क्या एक बिजनेस पॉइंट ऑफ व्यू से ही पता चलेगा, अगर आप आपने इफ यू हैव योर एप्लीकेशन इज लाइव राइट नाउ, तो यहाँ पे भी आपको पता चलेगा कि कितने यूजर अफेक्ट हो रहे हैं और कितने क्रैशेज आ रहे हैं। यहाँ पे अगर आप देखेंगे तो यहाँ पे 26th क्रैशेज हैपन ऑन योर एप्लीकेशन। सो दिस इज ऑल अबाउट द क्रैश एनालिटिक्स नाउ।
सो वन सेकंड रोहित, सो बेसिकली क्रैश Lytics will help us any moment if a project manager or client asks like what is the performance of application, how it is affecting users, how many number of crashes, then through this integration we can get that report very quickly. We can get the report by 7 days, 24 hours, 1 month, 6 months, 1 year, so we can check the performance for iOS Android application and we can get to know about the various crashes. This can also help us at the time of the development as well, and once the project goes live, then after we can utilize this.
Right.
So right now this all crashes happen when we are doing a integration and doing some for loops, while loop and etc. Then we can get to know like, yes, here the application is crashing and we have to fix this. So this is showing one of the event, and this is showing this crash happened 6 times and it is affected by one user. When you see the first object,
Yes, here.
The object output stream.java. So this happened 6 times. In which version? From version 1.0 to version 1.0. There is only a one version right now.
Right.
And it happened with the one user. So we can take an approach like most frequent crashes that we need to take care of first of all. You can see the first object happens 6 times, second object happens 6 times, the fourth object happened 3rd time. So first of all, we have to take care for the first and second, then the low priority, and then the 1 time. So that can help at the time of development as well. So that can reduce a gap between development team and a QA team. Like QA person is saying the crash is happening and our developer is saying crash is not happening. So this way we can figure out, and this way we can find out. Even when you click on this particular object, Rohit, can you please click this object output stream? Yes. So it will give you a more detail like this stack trace, the below one. This happened in Redmi Note 4. The OS is 7.4. This happened on a 26th June, 11:08 a.m. morning, the below one. And it will have a logs and data as well. So that can help you to like find out the crash. It is in a portrait. The app version 1.0. What was the RAM size? What was the disk size? So through these logs and events, we can figure out the issue and we can resolve it. So Crash Lytics is very beneficial tool at the time of development and as well as the after go live process. Okay, and in the Crash Lytics, you can see there are open issues. You can see the filters, filter issues, issue state below. That is open. So here as well, we can open issue, close issue, etc. The same like Jira, we can for the Crash Lytics, the developer and the QA, they can manage here as well. Okay.
Okay. Let's move on to performance. This is one part which we have not integrated in any other.
Hello, Rohit. Eden, you're still not audible. So, can you be a little loud?
Rohit, come closer to the mic. The volume is okay. Speaker is okay. You need to come a bit closer to your mic.
Okay, okay. Hello.
Yeah, hello. Much better.
Okay.
Yeah, thank you.
Okay. This is a performance part which we have not integrated till in any of the application. What we have to do here is we have to start integrating this SDK in each and every application from now. So we can able to identify the performance of the application as well. First of all, before explaining this part, I want to play a video for 30 seconds. Please watch it.
Right, your YouTube audio is not coming.
Sorry?
The video, YouTube video which you have made, that audio is not coming. Okay, that's fine.
Sorry?
Can I? That's fine. We can explain. No worries. Go ahead.
Okay. Let me stop this. This video is not working.
Video is working, but the audio is not coming only. Okay, you can play the whole video and we will explain them.
Okay.
So iOS and Android developer knows like integrating crash lighting, that is pod integration and Gradle integration. So same for the performance, we have to implement pod and the Gradle. So that is only a one line of code, and through this performance testing that YouTube audio was not getting play into this screen sharing, but this is basically about like when some client is complaining, I have a iPhone 4S device and I have a 2G services, then how my application will get performed? Some client will say, I have an iPhone 11, A13 Bionic chip, and I have a 4G connection or a Wi-Fi connection. If I am traveling on a road, then how my application will perform? I have a Wi-Fi in the office, then how my application will perform? So let's say example, splash screen is taking 8 seconds. So in which connection, which devices, it can give the whole dashboard. Like splash screen is taking 8 seconds. In this device, it is taking an average 9 seconds. In this device, with this connection, it is taking a seven seconds. And the average time is this. So this is the overall integration. Let's say some client is saying, like login API is taking too much time, so we can keep a timestamp tracking over here. Like this moment we have called the API and this moment we have received the response. So what is the difference in that in iOS, in Android? So we can get to know about this performance. So if we have integrated this tool from the day one, so this will start collecting the data at the time of development, at the time of quality, and after the project go live. So usually we have a maintenance contract for the 30 days. So within that period, we can get to know about the performance, like what is happening, where the application is going slow, when it is working fine. So if a client is performing, like application is very slow, then we can get all the reports, screen by screen reports, API by API report, and everything would be there. So we have integrated crash lightings from the quality. Performance we haven't taken yet. We have recently started performance with one of our project, which is a grow app. So now we will be starting with that. So if we integrate this from the day one, then it will help us a lot. So Rohit, if you go to the top, yes, there is a performance, then grow is a drop down. So there is an Android icon. You can switch to the iOS. So this kind of dashboard will come over there. We have recently integrated yesterday only. So how much the splash view controller, slow rendering, the country, the success response, the text, and etc. area, we can get to know here. This is similar like crash lightings dashboard only. And we can generate different reports. So this can help us. This can also help us checking a website performance as well. Sometimes we need to check a website performance tools. We can take the help of this tool as well. This will help in iOS, Android, and web as well. Right? So any question for this crash lightings or performance, or we can go for the test lab and app distribution.
Harshesh, sir, like as today's audience is more of technological guys as well, can you highlight more about, let's say, if you wanted to integrate performance SDK, what are the steps and very briefly way? Is there any custom codes required or how easy it is?
Yes, I can show you. Like as I said, like in iOS and Android, we do integration for the crash lightings, right? So if you go, yes, go to the Add SDK, do it. Mm-hmm. So it will open a get started notes for iOS and Android. So on the left side, when you see the Android, so Android people can get to know very quickly, like there are the dependencies. These are the Gradles we need to integrate, which is implementation com.google.firebase, Firebase preference 19.0.7. And the recompile, you have to recompile your project. If you click on iOS, right click on iOS. Yeah. So there is a pod, which is a pod Firebase/CrashLytics, which we usually do. So there is a one more command, pod Firebase/performance, and we have to install this pod. And the import Firebase is always in our project. And the next line, go down to it. Yes, this Firebase configure. This is also available in our project because we are using the push notification from Firebase and CrashLytics. So the only one line of code that can help. Only a single line of code, integrating a pod in iOS or integrating a Gradle in Android. So this can start getting your data. Okay.
Sounds good to me.
Hello.
Yes.
Yes. Yes. Here. I have one question regarding CrashLytics. Like yes. when I have used CrashLytics in a beta mode, like at that time it gets approx 24 hours to reflect in a dashboard as well as in an email of the crash. So currently it's getting immediately reflected in the dashboard, or it's taking time?
Currently, when CrashLytics was there from Fabric, it was sending a quick emails. It wasn't taking a too much time. In fact, this is also happening in CrashLytics of Firebase as well, which has acquired Fabric CrashLytics. So when you go to the project overview, users and settings, there are options like this email IDs will get email notification quickly, yes or no. So we have to check those marks. Then only you will be getting those emails, crash emails quickly on your email. Another thing, when we integrate CrashLytics, at the first moment, it takes 1 hour or 2 hours. Then after, once the project is properly in the configuration, then it wouldn't take too much time. It will start reflecting in 5 minutes, 10 minutes max. This is what I'm observing right now in various projects.
Okay. Because like when I have used in like 1 year ago in the beta mode of the Firebase CrashLytics, it takes almost 24 hours to reflect.
Correct.
Into our dashboard of this Firebase console. So that's why I stopped using Firebase CrashLytics and moved to the another tool for the CrashLytics.
Correct. Fabric was sending very quick emails and the Firebase beta version wasn't able, but now Firebase CrashLytics is able to send an email very quickly, but you need to go to the project setting, select a user and do the check marks. This will get a performance report, this will get CrashLytics report, this will get analytics report, etc., etc. Because we can add multiple users with editor, viewer, owner, different rights.
Asha, can you please show this setting where we can enable that?
Yeah. Rohit, can you go to the project overview, the left panel? Yes. See, the users and permissions are here. Go to users and permissions. These are the users and permission. We can add the roles from here. Right? Okay. Rohit, go up. Is Manthan there? Manthan, Vivek, Monali?
Yes, I'm there.
Yes, sir.
Monali, what was that setting we were doing in Yugo to get the quick emails?
I think we have to add member from here.
Add member, we can do it from here, right? But the okay, Rohit, can you click that Sagar or Rohit or Hasya? Any particular user? Yes. There are a different check marks.
I guess Rohit sir does not have all the privileges. He's an editor.
Yes. No,
just a second. Let me check in Maya as well. Because I have access. This setting I need to check.
Hasya, can you please try to log in with your email ID? I think this is login by Rohit email ID. I think that's why there is no permission.
This is the same thing. Okay, I'm going to share my screen. Rohit, you can put off your screen sharing. Okay. Now the same group app is here with my access. So, I don't remember exactly. I might need to go to my profile and check the related email getting and etc. But I will get back to you on this part. I can get back to you. I'll be showing on it. Okay. Rohit, you can see my screen or you can share your screen. Can we go for the test lab?
Yeah, right. Let me share my screen. Asya, please stop sharing your screen so I can also share my screen.
Now you can do.
Okay. Hello. Hello.
Yes, Rohit. We can hear you.
Okay. From this test lab, we can able to perform a test of the application from here. So let me do one practical and show you here. So, we are taking a robo. This is for a Android application, and I am going to deploy one APK file over here. This is Guru application. This is getting uploaded. Before that, I have to.
Okay, Rohit, sorry to interrupt you. Can you please go to the top, go to the docs, the right corner, which where is your the bell icon, Rohit, right side. Yeah, tap on the bell icon. Okay, the setting button, the top one. Yes. So now Rohit has a different access for the Grow app and the VTube project. So Rohit can click on the VTube live. Rohit, click on it. So here there are a check marks, right? Your project is nearing a plan limit for phone authentication. Then Rohit can receive an email. Then your project is nearing a plan limit of GB stored. Same like. So Sandeep and Keur, we can do this check marks. By in Fabric, by default, all the profiles was tick marked from the day one. So we were receiving the quick emails. But in Fire Crashlytics, it is like teamwork. So all the users wouldn't get access. We need to give access, or they can opt access to get an email for the Crashlytics and etc. So these are the tick marks.
So I think Ashay, these tick marks is for just giving the notification regarding your plan is going to be extend or your GB's storage is now. I think
no, there are many. You can, Rohit, you can scroll down, see the hosting related, app distribution related, prediction related, test lab related, etc. etc. As per the access, if I have given the owner access, they can access everything. If I have given the viewer access, they can get a limited access. If I have given the editor access, they will get a limited access. So if Rohit tick mark everything, then they will get the start receiving the emails in that particular thing.
But I just want to check that notification access, right? When the crash happened, at the same time, email will fire. That setting I am not able to see here.
Okay.
Okay.
Hello,
sir.
Rohit, I'm sharing my screen. Can you please put off again?
Okay.
Hello.
Yes.
Sandeep sir. उसके लिए आपको क्या है कि हमारा iOS में जो एडिट स्कीम आता है ना उसमें डिबग एनेबल करना पड़ता है वो फायरबेस का एक सेटिंग है कि जिससे आप एनेबल करोगे ना तो आपको डिबग में अगर कोई क्रेश होगा अब बराबर तो वो तुरंत जो क्रेश होगा ना तो आपको मेल आएगा वो एक डिबग का एडिट होता है वो करना पड़ता है एडिट स्कीम में
ओके संदीप एज यू कैन सी आई हैव अ ओनर एक्सेस फॉर द ग्रो ऐप प्रोजेक्ट और फॉर द VTube प्रोजेक्ट देन हियर दिस आर द टिक मार्क्स for the crash lightings.
Okay, so it will display for only owner, right?
Yes. Or a viewer or a editor. I think I have given the viewer access only to Rohit. So let's assume if I go to my VTube project, then also I will get the same kind of like notifications. So I'm switching to the another project. Now I'm going again to the settings. Right, these are the different projects. I can go to the VTube or a Yugo or another thing. See, I have a two tick marks and I can get it. Okay, Sandeep, can we move for the test lab?
Yes, fine, fine, continue. So I think all team members got the point from where we can enable that, right?
Yes, Sandeep bhai.
Okay, fine.
Okay. Rohit, you can share your screen and go for the test lab.
Okay. So here I was uploading a APK file to test, perform a test practical.
So basically what happens sometime, I had this issue at the time of Eagle Hills. Client was saying I have a Samsung Note 10 plus device and which I wasn't having at the Mumbai office or Ahmedabad office and wasn't able to find out in my circle. So I wasn't having that device. So I can virtually opt that device. We can select APK or IPA from this test lab. But for the IPA, for the iOS, we must need a AXI test and UI test. But yes, till then we can utilize for the Android as well. So I have selected one APK here. Now going ahead. Rohit, continue.
Yeah.
So at the time of the selection dimension, you can customize.
Huh.
You can customize different devices at the same moment. See, there are virtual devices. There are variety of devices. If client is saying, I'm not able to do this in the LG phone and we don't have that LG phone in the office, that particular OS we don't have. You can select a device and you can configure the OS here. Let's say you are picking HTC 10, API 26 or any device. Yes, this one, Samsung LA. We can do the local, the country. We can do portrait landscape. We can select the API level, which is the OS. We can opt this device. At the one moment, I can select more than one device. I can select a 5 device. You can Rohit, select one more device.
Two devices are selected.
So two devices are there. So what happens? Okay. Start this test. this taste will take a 5 minutes, 10 minutes. So let this taste run. You can run a max 5 physical or 10 virtual devices per day. Okay, maybe the selection has been happened. Rohit, you can switch to VTube, or I can switch. Okay, so okay, we will explain you here. So like this way you can configure your APK and the different devices, different OSs. These are the virtual devices, right? You can pick any number of devices. Yesterday we were doing a trial and error. That's why this we have done the our limit of daily 10 devices.
This will work. It will do.
Let's see.
So is there any limit for a day?
Yes, 10 devices, 10 virtual devices.
Here it is. I have made a solution.
Okay.
So this taste has started, right? So let this taste to be finished. Rohit, tap on a taste lab. We can show them up yesterday taste reports. Okay. Meanwhile.
Okay.
So one of the tests is running right now, but we can show them a previous report. So
yes.
Here you can see we did test with a Pixel device API level 26. So tap on it.
Yeah.
It will give you, it took 5 minutes and 2 seconds, 168 actions happen, one activity happened. And you can see the below graph, the crawling graph. So any client is saying, I am not able to go on a checkout screen. You can get this graph and you can claim, now this is going in your device. This is your virtual device. This is the hardware. This is the OS. And we can find out this graph. And you can download this image and you can give it. Also, this can help to track down and debug the issue between development team. See, the whole graph is coming there. If there is a login, then you can give a username and password as well. That's okay. The image will come there. Whole image you can take down. It will give you the actions, redirections, forward, backward, everything is there. So then knowing the flow of the project, that will also help here, right? Okay. In the app, there are logs. Logs can help you to know the warnings. No, nothing is there. The screenshots. These are the screenshots. You can download all the screenshots and you can give it to client or a PM or etc. whenever we need it.
During the test, this application has taken a couple of screenshots, which are all the screenshots which took by this application are here.
Right. Then at the top, we can have a video file as well.
Yes. And here
you can play the video file, and it took 5 minutes, 7 seconds to run the whole project in the test lab. So this is splash screen and language will come, then etc. etc. See, it will show you the pointer as well. So where the robo has clicked on the device. Okay, Rohit, go to the top. There is a performance.
Here we can get the performance related to the API, which API is taking how much time.
The launch activity, the particular screen, and as well, etc. etc. The device detail we can get here, the manufacturer, the brand, model, device. So this can help us configuring more than one device, portrait, landscape, different OSs, and we can taste at the one moment and we can generate various reports.
Here it is a response. Asya.
Yes, these are the number of seconds it took.
Took to respond.
Right.
Wait for respond, tap escape. know the response.
This taste lab works very well with the Android, the APK projects. It is also working fine with iOS, the IPA. But in iOS IPA, we need to provide a taste case from the UI taste, XE taste. So that we can plan out in the future to take down that activity and we can have the taste lab for the iOS as well. But yes, for the Android, at least we can take the help from this device. So let's say I am an iOS developer and I don't have an Android device with me, right? Then I can go here, I can take a device and I can do my taste. Right? Okay. So any query in this taste lab? Is it beneficial?
So definitely it seems to be very interesting. Okay, I think we need to more understand what all, like, you know, that parameters are there. Yes, like that missed vSync, what is missed vSync, what is high input latency and other things. What does, like, you know, slow UI thread means?
I think, sir, this is related to load balancing. In last month, we did load balance testing for a Yugo .qa domain in our project, which is done by Rohit and team. Arpan did that load balancing test, and we were discussing about this latency and the thread and etc. So I'm not technically aware with this latency and thread and the missed vSync and etc. But yes, Nilesh from server team.
I think this is related to this test only. You know,
right.
That is for server. So that must be for, like, you know, that mobile application only. So anyway, let's try to get this, like, you know, what is the use of this? And definitely this is very useful and interesting.
Yes, sir.
Sir, I want to add one more thing here. Like, you ask about this keywords. Like, slow UI thread means, like, it's a, let's say, for example, if we are moving from one screen to another screen, so how much lagging is there in between the screen navigation? It shows this slow UI thread, right? Can you scroll up? And the second option is high input latency. Like, some of the things have, like, say, for example, if in one of the screen we are we have multiple APIs calling and high level of performance related task going on in our particular screen. At that time, if something issues happen related to our application performance, then it will indicate in the second option. And our last option is slow bitmap upload. Like, say, for example, if we have any of the let's say image uploading task or image loading screens where we have image display in the screen. So if it takes too much time to the loading perspective or uploading perspective, then it indicates, okay, whether you need to work on that particular portion of the application or you have to just keep it right now, as of now. So, like, as of now, it's 0%. So it's perfectly working in this
application. Fine. So, yeah, let's try to, like, you know, read this. And I mean, like, you know, how to read this. And so it will help us out to fix the issues, right? Because if slow bitmap upload is coming, then where to find where this issue is? If, let's say, like, you know, slow UI that rendering is there, how, like, you know, on which all screens the issue is, that we can figure it out and fix that.
Yes, definitely.
See, I can see, like, you know, this is very beneficial for the, like, you know,
yes, sir,
the projects where we are not aware about, let's say, Serendipity. If Serendipity or Yugo has come to us, and if we are not sure about the entire flow and anything, then we can run this and we can get the idea, like, you know, what is the exact flow and other things. So I think that quick overview we will get from you.
Yes, taking a handover from another vendor, that moment yes. can get the help. As well as I remember last year when we did the VTube, there was a very lagging time. So you have given one suggestion to take the help of the timestamp when my API is calling, when I'm getting a success or a failure response and what moment the data is showing. So API calling was done in 7 seconds only, but the data showing was taking 20 seconds. So total was 27 seconds. So where I need to concentrate and when I where I need to work on an API front or showing the data front, like loading the data front. So this can help us. And we took that one day putting a timestamp, print logs and etc. That helped. But by doing a one pod or a this Gradle integration, we can get this help.
Yeah, definitely. It's very useful. Rohit, can you please click on the logs? I think logs are already there, but log is large. That's yes, sir. You need to perhaps download that. Click on logs.
Yes.
Download that. Yeah, download that. Let's see.
I think this is the similar log we get in the Android Studio.
Mm-hmm. Okay.
Something like that.
Read this, yeah. I think we need to check if we can read this and if we can do like, you know, some sort of improvement in our code or anywhere.
Yes.
Okay, fine. So keep exploring these all aspects and I think it's good. You guys can continue, please.
Okay. Thank you, sir. Okay, the next is the app distribution. So basically what happens, app distribution, it is similar to Divi or Deploy Ninja. But what happens from the Divi and Deploy Ninja, we cannot get to know like what version QA is using or a client is using. I have sent an email for the Divi link. Does client has downloaded that application? Does that application expired? What happened to the application? And if client got any crash or any issue, and then this app distribution will directly roll out here. So let's say going to the app distribution, there are different tester groups. We can have different testers group like internal QA team or a beta go live team or a client or etc. So yes. And you can, Rohit, you have created one group. Now, yes, within that group, you can add the multiple emails. Okay, one more like technical problem for a iOS application. We are always required to get a UDID from client and then only we can release a IPA, right? But here you do not need UDID. You can directly send the IPA. Client will get an email. There is a trust certificate. Tapping on it, it will allow any user with any UDID to download the application. So this is, I am right now in the dropdown for the Android. So it is asking me for the APK. If I am in a dropdown of iOS, then it will ask me for the IPA. So right now Rohit is uploading. Hold on Rohit. Otherwise, yes, there is.
Yes, sir. I was showing.
So Rohit is uploading a APK.
First of all, I have created a group over here and then I am uploading a APK or IPA file we can upload from here.
So we can get to know, like I have given the release for version 1.3, then client has accepted that invitation.
Yes.
Does client has downloaded the application? Yes or no? We can get all the reports here. Okay.
Suppose
at testers.
Okay.
That group is empty. I think it is in QA. QA. Yes. To select a users from QA.
No, whole group I have selected.
Okay, done. Then next. This is release note. We can write down all the things like in this build, we have a login, registration, forgot password, change password, etc. Right? And we can distribute to two testers. Same like we can do for the IPA as well for iOS. And don't need for the UDID. right? So as you can see, this is version 1.0. I have sent on a 27th June morning 10:50. Rohit has received that email. Rohit will receive in some time. Yeah, now you have an invitation. Rohit has tapped on an invitation. And there will be an instruction. What happens with the client? Like, I have received a Divi link, Deploy Ninja, but what I need to do now? So here through the app distribution, the pre-template, this how to do, how to start testing, that steps are there for Android and for iOS as well. Get the setup, accept invitation, enable installation from unknown source. That is a major query for the iOS release, Android releases. Right,
email,
so all
the email ID also should enable in your mobile phone.
Yes, and you can download and you can taste it. Okay, mm-hmm. Rohit, can you go back to the crash? Yes. Okay, so you see there are two invited. Zero has accepted and zero has downloaded. So if client or a QA team or someone is saying like, I have received your application, I have started testing, then through this we can get to know, are they correct or not? Where are the gaps? This can help us to fill up the gaps. So we can start using this app distribution in iOS and Android instead of Divi and a Deploy Ninja. In Divi, yes, it will that URL will expire within a 1 day. If I am signed in, then it will expire in a 3 days. But this URLs wouldn't expire.
And we can resend from here.
We can resend from here as well. The same build will go. Mm-hmm. So if I don't have a APK or IPA in my computer, I can open my mobile, Firebase, go to app distribution, and same release I can send another time. Unless I need to wait for the iOS developer and Android developer to give me IPA and APK and generate a Divi again. So this can help in that way.
We can revoke the access before giving a new invitation to client, because many times it happens that client without uninstalling the previous application, he or she start installing the new one. So we can revoke the access from here, and we can send the another new version of the build from here.
Okay, so this is about like quality tab. Mm-hmm. Now I guess we can give it to Vishal Jani from marketing team.
Ashish, a quick question on the distribution. Yes. So yes, let's say we are into the distributions and I have received the email. If I am forwarding that email to somebody else, will he able to access the same, or unless and until he is mentioning to invitation, only those person can see those?
No, let me answer your question. That if you will forward this invitation to someone else, mm-hmm. But he or she needs to be this email ID needs to be in the mobile application, mobile okay. phone. Then only he or she can be able to access this one.
But the mobile application, so email address in mm-hmm. your email will remain the same. Mm-hmm. I'm just forwarding the same email to somebody. Let's say the same email you are forwarding to Sandeep sir, mm-hmm. and his email ID is not there. So if you follow the step, will he able to download the application?
I need to check on this. Ideally, it wouldn't allow, because this Fabric's quality app distribution saying it would go on a particular invitation only. Mm-hmm. But yes, you can download the APK file. It will available in the file manager. And from file manager, we can share to another users from Android phones and etc. But yes, Divi has an option to share that URL, or a Deploy Ninja has an option to share that URL directly, and anyone can download.
Yeah.
So there is a one disadvantage. There could be a disadvantage with our distribution, but the yes, the benefit is that I wouldn't require to wait for the UDID for the iOS. I can get to know like which version QA is using, which version client is using. So that can reduce a gap. Generally what happens, there could be a like debate. I have downloaded application and this is happening, and when you're checking here, that is not happening. And then all of a sudden we get to know, okay, yesterday I got a new release and I haven't checked. So that case is that gaps we can reduce from this app distribution. Sure. Yes, sharing a Divi URL and deploy Ninja, that would be a very rare case, 1 out of 100. But the another benefits are there.
Yeah, definitely. I was just wanted to understand. That's it. No problems.
Yeah. One more question. When I add any team member in that particular distribution group, is it mandatory to have Gmail account?
No. It can go on any domain.
Okay.
Okay. Any queries for this quality dev, or we can quickly switch to... Asya. Yes.
I have one query. I just want to ask regarding the distribution of the iOS application.
Yes.
Android, what happened? We can directly share the APK to someone. We can directly install. No worry there. But in the iOS case, there is the more privacy and security. So if we go with the IPA with the distributions of the Firebase, what client or what the other person should take a priority? Like he need to install any Firebase distribution app before installing from the invitation? Do require yes. anything like application from the Firebase or else?
Correct.
Just so like in the test flight, we need to install test flight first. Then we can get invitation from the Apple and user can tap on that and that open on the test flight. In such a case, required for the Firebase or the iOS application?
Yes, it is required. It is similar like if I am downloading enterprise application, which is account of $299, right? So similar like when I download enterprise application, first of all, it will ask me to download the trust certificate, and that trust certificate goes to the settings.
Yes, right. So
right? Same way, yeah. if I give your email address and I send one IPA, then at the first step, it will give you the how to start testing. It will give you the steps. Like you can tap on this and it will download the certificate. Now you can go to your settings, go to trust certificates, and you can allow this trust certificate. Now, yeah. When you allow that trust certificate, when you go to next time to this email, it will ask you, now you can download.
Yes, that is the case of the enterprise application, right? We can install that profile certificate and anyone can install without UUID. But
correct.
In the case of the developer certificate, and we are sharing the application to the someone using a Firebase distribution. So at that time, what step we require? Do require any applications and install and then any certificate from the Firebase?
Yeah, mobile provisioning profile will get automatically installed. And that is the like feature of app distribution. Let's say I don't have your device UDID and I share application IPA, then you can directly download the certificate, the trust certificate and mobile provisioning profile will get downloaded in your device and it would be shared. First of all, the invitation goes. There are two stages for IPA. First, the invitation. When you accept the invitation, it will download trust certificate and mobile provisioning profile. When it will get downloaded, your tick mark in the tester group, it will be activated. And the second email will go for the application release. So there are okay. two steps in the iOS.
Okay. So when we are tapping on the invitation email, it will open.
Open with the pre. Or... Yes. So let's try right now. Just a second. Through we are in a Grow app, right? So Rohit has shared his email. Okay. Let me go to. Rohit, yesterday I sent you email regarding this invitation. Can you open that? We were trying yesterday, if you remember.
Yesterday email.
The unread email. No. Not this one. The unread, go up. Yes. Grow via Firebase. You have been invited to taste Grow for iOS. Yes, this email subject. So Sandeep, as you can see here.
Yes, right. So now when we tap on the set setup, they just accept invitation, right?
And right.
There any application we require like test flight for the iOS in such a way we require any distribution application for the Firebase?
No, it will directly download the trust certificate and you can go ahead.
Okay, fine.
This taps on this is not coming right now here because it is open in the Linux, the system. If it is in a device, then it can give you the further steps for that.
Yes, fine. It's good.
Okay. Okay. Any more questions for this quality tab? There are more interesting topics.
I have one question, Ashya.
Yes.
You told us that we can also add username and password for test lab.
Yes.
So from where we can add that?
We can show you. Rohit, can you tap on a run test? And pick up one more time this GrowApp APK file. Continue. Here I can select different devices and the additional options, the below one.
Yes.
Here I can add the username and password, and I can add a test runtime. It will over in a 5 minutes, 10 minutes, etc.
Okay.
The deep links and etc. Okay.
One more question here, Asya.
Yes.
So this is quite useful in terms of for applications who has direct, simple, convenient mechanism of username and password as an authentication. Okay. But say if in your application there are multiple modes of authentication, say login with Google, login with
or OTP or
Apple, etc. Those other authentication mechanism. So will that robot test also perform in that perspective?
Ideally no, because OTP and such things are not there. This username resource and the username field, it is actually exactly as per the API field, API request parameter which we are passing, and yes, it is taking in that concern. So OTP and etc. is not there. So that moment there is a disadvantage.
Yes, so that hidden means feature will not be available, or the test would not be performed on those perspective, taking consideration either login with Google or Facebook or other social mechanism, right?
Correct. Right. But as you see the track record of Firebase, they are growing daily and daily, so they will come up with some option.
Yeah, hopefully. Thank you.
Yes. Okay.
Yes, and Hasya, for the iOS test lab, we require to write each and every test cases for the application.
Yes. Right? Yeah, the taxi test and UI test. Correct. The taxi test and UI test we need to write down, and that script we need to upload here along with the IPA file. So we are still not in the phase of UI test and taxi test. But yes, for the Android, at least we can get the benefit. For the IPA iOS, we can look down sometime.
Yes, right.
First of all, we need to go to the XE test and UI test. That will also help in a manual as well. So let's say if I am giving a IPA today for any project, so I have a predefined test cases in XE test and UI test, and I can roll out. I can do my own unit testing rather than going to the application and surfing for the 1 hour or 2 hour. So that is also good aspect for XE test and UI test. Yes, that is time consuming. But if we achieve that and we start integrating in all of other projects, future projects, along with a better time for the development, then we can get that benefit in the Firebase as well.
Yes, right. Right, good. So at least we can continue with the Android applications who have no any authentication or OTP like flow in between. Then we can go ahead and can check all the reports. And correct. Right? Yes. Correct. That's good.
Yes. So let's assume you have taken the handover for IIFL and IIFL as a APK. So you can go to the test lab and you can generate that graph log and the time logs, this login API is taking this, and that report you can get a zip or a rare file and you can keep it somewhere. So in future, if you want to explain to your resources, like you need to go this, that can also help. Like what is the time taking in the login? That can also help. If client is saying like earlier the prior developer was working better and now you have derailed my product. So we can claim on that base.
Yes, right. But Hasya, where you are OTP processing between of the login, then we cannot go with this, right? That is correct. The drawback.
Correct.
Yes.
That is the drawback. Every system, you know, have some benefits and drawbacks as well. But at least this can help somewhere.
Yes,
we are
right,
not
right.
taking
yes,
this right. benefit. Yes. We can start at least taking these benefits.
Yes, yes, right.
Also, like for the performance, Crashlytics, the taste, etc. If I make a go live today and I'm going to integrate, then there is no meaning. It should be from the day one. So it will start collecting the data. Because yesterday I've integrated performance for the iOS, but it doesn't have a data because that IP I haven't given to Rohit, the QA team or a client. So if I have integrated that performance in iOS from the day one, then I will be start getting the data. Okay. Any other question?
No, not from my side. Anyone else have any issue or any query?
Yes, Hasya. Hello.
Yes, Vasim.
I would like to know that in Taste Lab, can we mock taste for location tracking anything? Is there any mechanism available in Taste Lab?
No. That tool is not available.
Okay.
Right now, this is doing like a crawling, like where the user application is going, the robot taste. We have a XE taste and UI taste in iOS, similar like you have a robot taste in a Android. So that is a robot only which crawls within the application and that gives you the data.
Okay, thank you.
Okay, any other questions, sir? This performance is also happening in web as well. So we can take that help there as well.
One more, Hasya. In Crashlytics, can you tell me which kind of crashes we can solve, like system level crashes or application level crashes?
Application level crashes. We have like a specific in Android, the VTube, we have taken Crashlytics and you know, that reports from the Play Store. We were not able to get the report for the system level, which goes beyond the memory crashes. Even in the iOS, when we get EXEC bad access, which is going beyond the memory. Like I have 8 GB of device, RAM device, and I get the whole system packed with the memory, then it is crashing the application. Yes, definitely. That crash log, even not providing by iOS, not providing by Play Store, App Store, any.
Or I think, is there no any technique that we can also get that kind of crashes in Crashlytics? Means any, is there any settings, all those things?
No, I don't think so. I haven't explored in that thing. But yes, at least let's start for that thing. We can explore. For the Crashlytics, might be I have explored for the 50%. Now let's start using this in another, all the projects. And we can get to know more into it.
Okay.
Okay. Can we go for analytics? Are we good for a quality?
Yes, definitely. We can move.
Okay. Rohit, thank you so much for this quality related things. We can hand over to Vishal, who can explain us a very interesting things for the analytical point of view, marketing point of view, and some of the another concept we are coming for the push notification, in-app messaging, and etc. things. So for the analytics, I have given VTube access to Vishal because yes, when we talk about the data should be there. That analytics integration we should be doing. Then only the data will get populated within a 24 hours, 7 days, 30 days, 1 month, 1 year. And once the data is there, then only we can analyze. So Vishal can take it further.
Yeah. Thank you, Asya.
My screen is visible to everyone.
Yes, Vishal.
Okay. So this is the dashboard for analytic part, and it will help you to analyze the different kind of data for your application, like for tracking of your active user or tracking of your events, like tracking of your conversion for e-commerce site or tracking for your conversion for like subscription based site. And you can analyze your audience via this functionality. So there are different features available in this section. So let's start with the dashboard. So yes, this is the last 28 days data. You can modify it from here. You can select the timeline and check your data analysis. So if we can check the data of last 28 days, there is a list of active users day by day, and it will also give you comparison for last month as well. So here the data comparison between 28 May to 26 June to April 30 to May 29. So you can compare your app's performance with respect to your last month data. It also allows you to check the active user per minute data. So if we can check last 30 minutes data, it here is the list. Like before 7 minutes, there is only 2 active user, but before 6 minutes, there is 8 active users on our app. So we can definitely have a track of your conversion, like users who are converting into your product sale or like your monthly subscription or that stuff. So if you want to get the numbers of conversion in your app for a particular time period, you can check the data here. Also, you are able to get the data of your daily users engagement. So this is the data like every user spent on your mobile application, like 12 minute and 3 second is the average data for your users. I will explain you more to how to filterize that data in the next section. We can also check the revenue here. If we have a link between, like, if we are spending money on our AdWords campaign or AdMob campaign, we can check like how much revenue we are able to generate within last month or like last 90 days. So we can have that data here. We can verify it. We can also have like stability data of our app, like for Android and iOS version. So it will show you the last date's data, like here in this timeline, it's 26 June. So it will show you that how many crash-free users are there in percentage formula. So in this scenario, it's 0%, it's good. Okay, so there is a multiple release of your app, and whether it is which version or is it successful or not, you can check here. Also validate the reason. And the acquisition part shows you like from the source of your mobile application users, whether the user downloaded from direct from link or like from Google Pay or iOS, you can check it over there. Yeah, so retention. So every business needs to check their retention users, like for application, if user download your application and just not using it on daily basis, then it has no use. Like it's just application in the user's phone. But you can check your application's connectivity, like from week one, there is 100%, like the whole number of users who download this app in this week.
But after the second week, the active user is only 32%. Like retention is 39%. The next week, it go decreasing. So it will be decreased day by day, week by week. But you need to make sure like this retention rate will be reduced for a betterment of client, for betterment of business. You can also have facility to check the audience or like sessions demography, like from which country your audience or your major sessions are there. Like from here in this case, it's from Brazil. So Brazil has highest sessions, and a total of 46% of users comes from Brazil in this time range. So you can check the multiple factor like device, also have demographic like male female data, gender specific, age specific data, and this will help the marketing team to you market your app. Like some application or some business has the only female users target, so they can definitely run campaign for the female users based on this data. So you can help your marketing team with this ad, with this data, that our major application users are from 18 to 34 age group. So you can emphasize your efforts on this age group only. So it will help us to save our cost. Also, if you want to expand your demographic reach, like if you want to cater the audience from 45 to 64 age, as you don't have an audience for that users, so you can do a separate campaign for that user as well. So it will help you with the marketing marketing theme. You can market your campaign based on this data, and it will help you to gain a good results in terms of e-commerce client. It will help you to have a good ROI. Yeah, so it will give you comparison of Android and iOS as well. So 56% users from Android and 44% users from iOS. So you can bifurcate your a platform as well based on these results. So if we go in detail, like we can check.
Vishal, can you come closer to the mic?
Yeah, sure. Now it's audible, correct?
Yes.
Okay. So this event tab will indicate you a different event. So first question will be in your mind when you are just starting Firebase, like why Firebase and why not Google Analytics? Both can give you a data. Both can facilitate you to track your data. But why Firebase? So Firebase will help you to have a inbuilt event. Like there are a multiple inbuilt event in Firebase. So you developer don't need to create that event, and you can simply get the data for a inbuilt event. Though there is a facility to create a customized event, but there is also a recommendation of event from Firebase only. So there they have a good number of data. So which data can help the user based on your business. So just sharing you one screen. Yeah, so this is the list of automatic events available in Firebase. There is a more events available, but this is just simple view of automatic events available in the Firebase Analytics.
So how event can help us, like these are the default events, and we can generate our own events by passing a class name or a screen name. Yeah. So let's say example, if client is complaining, I have 100 downloads, but there are only 50% user is doing a login. So through these events, we can get to know about the where user is redirecting, where user is going, what is the taste of the user. So if we go to the funnel, Vishal, can we see for the funnel?
Yeah.
Yeah. So funnel is basically like that can help to, okay, we did one taste yesterday, right?
Yeah, so we can customize our funnel
based on the event, like there is a filter available. It's there is filter available of platform, stream, audience name, and user property. So user property, you can have a data of it by default event only. So if a user is based on male, female, you can create this funnel. But the main part is you can also have usage of different events in creating different user properties. Like
you can see this funnel has a first open. Can you go back one more time to the funnels and the select the exercise one, the first one? Okay, now you see the first open, the application who download and do the first open in Android. So this is the first event, first open. So 14,000 times the people have downloaded application, and how many number of times people do login? Then that is 1500 times. So repeated logins are there. So if client is saying like 50% is login is happening, then through this we can claim like 100% login is happening after the application download. Right? If someone is saying like I don't user is the flow is not correct, user is not able to go to the checkout, then we can create that funnel. How many number of application is getting download? They can go to the product category, product detail, tap on a add to cart button, go to the cart screen, then checkout, then the checkout screen. So this funnels we can create, and that can give us a help to analyze the project. So basically the interaction with this analytics and the marketing team, Vishal, we are trying to like, these are very small things. The events we have achieved in Yugo within a one day. In VTube, we have achieved within a one day. For the analytics, there is only a one pod and the Gradle. But this data will get start populating here. So what happens after a one project go live, if we talk about the second phase with the client, then what data we need to have, like in which direction we need to work, that we can have it here. We can give the good examples, like marketing examples to client. Like we have a 68% males on this application. So you can send a push notifications, emails, SMS in this related. We have an age group of 18 to 24. So there is a new iPhone launch, that push notification will work. But if I roll out a push notification related to kids toy, then that wouldn't work, right? So that kind of analytics we can do here. So this is from the development team, we are only required to integrate different pods for analytics. There is only a one pod and the rest of the things will start getting populated. We recently in the Yugo, we have achieved the events. So events are basically a class name, right? So if you go to the down this about underscore us, the about us page, the change password page. So we have given the specific names as well. So what I did, I've write down all the screen names and they given the specific name and then they have integrated the logs and the events, which can be done within a one single day in iOS and Android. For 40 to 60 screens. And after these events, this funnels, this conversions, the audience, then all other things we can get to know. What is the latest release we can get to know? What is the audience? Vishal, can you go to the audience?
Yeah.
Now, okay, all purchasers, all users, okay. No problem. Fine. So go down. So here you can see we have a majorly users on Android, the 56%, the age group and the technology go up. From which domain we are getting the users? It is from the technology and mobile enthusiast. Which country? Right. So if I roll out a one push notification like happy independence or something for the India, then that wouldn't work here because the most of the users from the Brazil, United States and Canada. So if I roll out a push notification related to Black Lives Matter, then it will take a benefit, right? Are you getting me? Like in which direction we are going? So if doing a small thing at the time of the development that can help. So what happens, we are doing only analytical integration whenever marketing team needs. But if we start doing from the day one in all of the project, then it can help in the second phase, retain the client, retain the business, give a ROI to the client. If we give the ROI to the client, client will again come to the us only, right? So these are the things. If I have a 70% on women's, then if I roll out a women's day notification or an email or a SMS, then it will take it, right? On a one day, we tried a push notification directly from this Firebase on this YouTube. Me and the client Aaron, we tried one push notification. Can you go to the dashboard, Vishal? Okay, there is a stream view on the right. So you can see there are 87 live users right now. So in the United States, we can see at the India time at 8 p.m. the evening, there are thousands of users in the United States, Canada, and etc. places. So if I roll out a push notification that moment, then they will take it quickly. So there are 83 users right now. The OS level and etc. information is there. The top version is 1.9, which is Android for the 50 users. Right? The events are there. So me and Aaron tried for the one push notification directly from here. And from that 83 users, these users all of a sudden jumped to 3,000 active users all of a sudden. And the AWS server that went down. So later on, client has upgraded the AWS server. So they can get to know like this performance increase, this many users all of a sudden to the application, then what can happen? We also get to know about that. So this is mostly like analytics. Yes. So user properties, latest release and etc. things.
Yeah, so it will also help you to coordinate with the marketing team. Like sometimes what happened, marketing team will be from other region or like from other agency. So if you have a knowledge of like how it works, how we can calculate the event, how we can check the performance, like how we can calculate the conversions and made events for that. So it will be benefited for you. You can check the details from Firebase Analytics itself and you can guide them or like you can suggest client that it's working or it's not working. We need to do this. So you will have like a proof or like a real-time data to convince your client for any issue.
Right.
In case of e-commerce, there is a major goal to increase the sales. Like there are multiple products available, so you need to define your sales. But in case of other apps, like if we can talk about Zomato and that, they do also have paid memberships. So you can define that conversion in your Firebase Analytics, and you can have data for that. And you can beautiful part of this tracking is like you can make a list of user properties. You can define your audience. Once you have defined your audience, you can utilize it for any sort of promotion. So if you have a like audience of purchasers, so number of users who had purchased your products since last, if we can say 90 days, so you can define that audience and you can have a filter data of that audience, like average time for that audience on your site. You can have multiple variation, as Asya said, that if you want to do a push notification or like do in-app promotion ads, so you can suggest that we don't need to do this promotion for entire audience. We can showcase these ads to only our frequent buyers or like power buyers who have bought more than 3 products. So there is a segmentation available and we can define that with the help of this tool. So it will help you in this scenario. you can create audience from here, like based on events. You can have a multiple events by your own from customized events, like, and if someone has opened a particular registration page in last, we can say 90 days.
So from development perspective, we just need to run out a pod or a Gradle and integrate the events. Then for the this rest of the things, that is part of the like marketing team. They can do this. And for the further development action, they can suggest us. Like there is a flow problem in this checkout. So we need to do this screen to this screen. So it can help and etc. That they can give a suggestion. So StreamView and different another aspect are very good tools for the analytics.
Yeah, definitely.
Okay, we are already 11:30. So what is all of your preference? Like, shall we go for another? Like, I need to explain a grow tab. There are a different 5-7 functionalities. So can we do it right now or in the next week, next Saturday?
Hasi sir, already 10 people left from this conversations.
Yeah, so better like for the, okay, Vishal, just quickly one moment. Can you scroll down to the grow?
Yeah.
So yes, there are interesting topics like predictions, A-B testing, cloud messaging. Cloud messaging is our push notification, the in-app messaging, the remote config, and etc. So definitely, sir, we can have it in next week. But yes, these are the very interesting topics, very, very small things. Only a pod and another things need to be integrated, and we can have the many multifold benefits in this. So we shall, we can do it in next Saturday.
Okay. Just lastly, show you the integration part. Like if we want to integrate different tools like Google Analytics or Google AdWords or say AdMob or BigQuery, we can integrate it. This functionality is available. So from setting, we can go to the integration tab, and there are different software or third-party software available. So we can connect our Firebase Analytics data with these third-party tools, and we can have the detailed reporting, and we can have help with our import audience from Firebase Analytics to our AdWords and different tools.
Vasim, ANR events and crash data, we can pull it from Google Play. See, there is a tool.
Yes.
This is also helpful in Slack. This is also helpful in Jira. Automatically create issue in Jira. So that is one more beneficial tool.
Yeah, so that's it from my end. If anyone has any doubt, they can ask.
Vishal, I have one question.
Yeah.
Can you please go to funnel tab? Please click on people who search. We had added one for login, I think. One event for logging.
The above one, the exercise.
Yeah, the first one.
Yes, yes, yes. Can you please open that?
Yeah, sure.
Oh.
Yes.
There were percentage which are greater than 100.
Yeah.
It means that suppose there are 100 users who have installed the app, and the people are more than it who are logging.
Yeah.
Right?
Yeah.
Suppose we have 100 people who have downloaded the application, and then only 10 people log in and log out for 10 times. So a total login will be 100.
So it will be 100% or 10%?
It will be 10%.
10% only. It will be unique data only.
Okay, then how here the percentage is above 100?
Yeah, so what happened? User have multiple email ID for to get offer. Like there are a multiple offer for first sign up. So for example, in Paytm, in starting days, they give you 100 rupees cash back on first recharge.
Yeah.
So if I have a multiple email ID and if I have multiple numbers with me, then I will definitely do a multiple login and get the offer for my app.
Okay, so this is done by device ID or IP address like that?
Maybe IP address, because I'm not sure of event code, but you have facility to track both. Like if you just want to track the first time login and if you want to set up like you cannot have multiple email ID login with the same app, then you can definitely create custom event for that.
Okay, thank you.
Okay, Marcy sir.
Thanks, guys. Thank you so much. It was a really insightful session today. We got to know some really useful things which you are facing into our day-to-day, let's say, like job, like performance and crash and everything. So I guess it will be helpful. Thank you so much, Vishal, for joining in and sharing the details. Thank you, Rohit, for sharing your insights. And thank you so much, Hasya sir, for providing you all this interest to make this happen and showing all this insights. Thank you so much, guys. Have a great weekend.
Yeah, thank you.
Thank you, everyone.
Thank you, everyone, for your time.